Hare Krishna, welcome all of you for the session number 6, Ask for God's Company or His Pocket's Penny. Before we proceed, we will offer our prayers.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare
హరినామ సంకీర్తనకి శ్రీల ప్రభుపాదికి ఓం అజ్ఞాన తిమిరంధస్య జ్ఞానాంజన శలాకయా చక్షుః ఉన్మీలితం యేన తస్మై శ్రీ గురవే నమః. నమావోం విష్ణుపాదాయ కృష్ణ ప్రేష్ఠాయ భూతలే శ్రీమతే భక్తి వేదాంత స్వామినితి నామినే. నమస్తే సారస్వతే దేవే గౌరవాణీ ప్రచారిణే నిర్విశేషశూన్యవాదీ పాశ్చాత్యదేశతారిణే వాంఛాకల్పతరుభ్యశ్చ కృపాసింధుభ్య ఏవ చ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. జయ శ్రీకృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభు నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధర శ్రీవాసాది గౌరభక్తవృంద. హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే, హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే. ఆస్క్ ఫర్ గాడ్స్ కంపెనీ ఆర్ హిస్ పాకెట్స్ పెనీ. వాట్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్? యాక్చువల్లీ దెర్ ఆర్ పీపుల్ హూ గో టు ద టెంపుల్ టు ఆస్క్ గాడ్, ఓ గాడ్ ప్లీజ్ పాస్ మీ ఇన్ మై ఎగ్జామ్, ఓ గాడ్ ప్లీజ్ హెల్ప్ మీ ఆన్ మై డిగ్రీ, oh god please fetch me a job, oh god please give me promotion in the job, oh god please expand my business, I'll give you some fruit or flower or water a little bit, instead you offer me a big profit in my business, 20 lakh rupees, 50 lakh rupees. People actually think God is there just to fulfill their demands. And this type of approach to God is very commonly well known. So people, do they really love God or do they love his pocket? So let us see in this session today. We are proceeding with the further verses of the Bhagavad Gita chapter 1 from 11 to 20 of the first chapter today. And till now we have seen these things like me to we. Arjuna always thought of we, Yudhishthira, Maharaj, Arjuna, all the Pandavas. But Duryodhana always thought like this: my army, my skills, my diplomacy, I'll finish this Pandavas and take over the rule of the whole world. And those people who always think, me, mine, they also make many crooked plans to win in the game, sometimes even playing a foul game. Like Prabhupada says about Yudhishthira, you can see a big difference between Yudhishthira and Duryodhana here. Yudhishthira is thinking, everything belongs to Lord Krishna. Duryodhana is my brother, and all other brothers of Duryodhana are also my brothers. Whether I get kingship or I have to live in the forest, we will do what Lord Krishna wants us to do. And in case I occupy the rule, I can even share my kingdom with Duryodhana. He was even ready to live with 5 villages, you all know. And Yudhishthira was not very happy with the battle. Why fight like dogs for a piece of meat, he asked. Look at his abundance mentality of Yudhishthira Maharaj. On the other hand, see Duryodhana, he is always thinking in terms of, you know, how I can take over everything and wipe out the Pandavas. So this, he made many crooked plans, which we heard in the previous classes, isn't it? He was I conscious, I me mine conscious. So Prabhupada talks in the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto 1.5.11, Srimad Bhagavatam. He says, while preparing this commentation on this particular stanza of Srimad Bhagavatam, we have a crisis before us. In 1965, he is saying, our neighboring friend China has attacked the border of India with a militaristic spirit. The reason is that they lived in those days in an atmosphere of God consciousness. And every country over the surface of the world was God-fearing, pure-hearted and simple. And therefore, and there was no question of political diplomacy. Three words Prabhupada is using: pure-hearted, simple, and God-fearing. Pandavas were actually God-fearing, which means they were surrendered to Krishna. And they were pure-hearted. They were not greedy. And they were simple. So, they were so simple, they could live in the forest for 12 years. They were so simple, they could accept just 5 villages. They were so simple that despite Duryodhana hatching many plots to kill Pandavas, they considered him their own brother. They were so simple. Therefore, Yudhishthira is called Ajata Shatru, for whom enemy is not born. So, it's not only with Pandavas and Kauravas. Prabhupada is telling in recent times, 1965, there was a militaristic spirit between China and India for a desolate land. You can't do anything with that land. Why China and India were friends before, now they have become enemies. Prabhupada says the reason is because they have, instead of keeping God-centered life, they became godless. Because instead of being pure-hearted by chanting Lord's names, they became impure at heart. Impurity means, like, sometimes one child wants to take all the toys of all the children and say that you all get lost, I will enjoy all these toys myself. That's what Alexander wanted to do, Hitler wanted to do, many other fellows wanted to do in this world. That's impurity, greed. Here we are proceeding from Mahabharata. There is one very important story that happens in Dwarka. Once Duryodhana had sent all the, after the Kurukshetra war was declared, he had sent all the messengers to different parts of the world to get allies and support from various kings. But he thought, as far as Krishna is concerned, I should personally go. So he personally went to Dwarka, and he was about to enter the palace doors. At the time, Arjuna arrived there, and Arjuna and Duryodhana met each other. They shook hands and they both entered. And when they went in, they saw Krishna was lying in the bed. And Duryodhana went and sat by the side of Krishna, because he had come for a business deal. He wanted to actually make sure that Krishna gives him sufficient support for the Kurukshetra battle. And Arjuna, being a natural devotee of Krishna, very affectionately stood at the lotus feet of Krishna, waiting for Krishna to get up, with folded palms, as you see in the picture. And he had tears of affection for Krishna. Seeing Krishna, he was very pleased. So as soon as Krishna got up, first he saw Arjuna. And then he turned around and saw Duryodhana. So now Duryodhana told him, you see Krishna, you are relative to both of us. Therefore, you should be disposed equally towards both me and Arjuna, he said. And also he said, I arrived before Arjuna. Therefore, you should assist me in the war and you should not assist the Pandavas. Because he said, this is the practice of any good man in this world and you are the best of all men. He told Krishna. Basically, he openly told him, you support me and don't support Pandavas. Because I came first and I entered the palace first. Therefore, I should be given the first chance. So, Krishna told Duryodhana that, you see, I agree that you came first. But when I opened my eyes, I saw Arjuna first. He was sitting at my feet. I saw him first and then I saw you. Besides that, Arjuna is younger to you. Younger one should be given the first opportunity for choosing. So, and then Krishna said, I have an army of 1,000,000 soldiers called Narayana Sena Yadus. I can give that 1,000,000 soldiers to one of you. And I can myself join the other side. But let me tell you, I am not going to lift any weapon. So, you can decide which one you wish. And as soon as Duryodhana heard it, he started waiting with bated breath. What is Arjuna going to choose? If Arjuna chooses the 1,000,000 soldiers, I am gone. What will he do with useless Krishna who doesn't lift any weapons in the battle? Then I will be defeated. So, he was waiting. In case Arjuna would choose 1,000,000 soldiers of Narayana Sena, then Duryodhana thought of protesting. But without any hesitation, Arjuna quickly chose Krishna. And Duryodhana could not even conceal his joy. He said, oh Keshava, Arjuna has chosen you. So, I am left with only Narayana Sena. I will take that. Thank you. Bye bye. He went away. And afterwards, Krishna asked Arjuna, why did you choose me? And Arjuna confidently told Krishna, wherever you are, Krishna, that side will gain the victory. Arjuna was fully confident. So, you can see, this is the devotional spirit of Arjuna, which is the most essential ingredient in understanding Bhagavad Gita. Because Arjuna understood, I may have many, many qualifications. Our mental qualifications are like string of zeros. And having Krishna with us is like putting one in the front. If I have a B.Tech, I put 1 0. If I have M.Tech, 2 zeros. I have a PhD, 3rd 0. But if I add Krishna here, it becomes 1,000. Then it is valuable. Like T.D. Singh, who became Bhakti Swarup Damodar Maharaj. He got a degree from Illinois State University and he became Prabhupada's disciple. Then his degree was very valuable in establishing the message of Gita, scientifically. So in this way, Arjuna was very confident that all of the material qualifications are useless without adding Krishna. One. But Duryodhana was actually materially calculative. He never understood Krishna's supremacy. Yeah. Therefore, he thought Arjuna sentimentally chose Krishna out of love for him foolishly. Ha ha, he was thinking like that. He thought he is more intelligent. So, he was very selfish, Duryodhana. Like you see here, what Pandavas thought. Here, Arjuna is thinking here. He says, Krishna is my Lord and friend. He is Parabrahma. Parabrahma, Paramdhama, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan, Purusham Shashvatam, Divyam Adi, Devam Ajam Vibham. Like that, Arjuna prays. My victory is only in his company. I want Krishna, not his energies. His friendship alone is enough for me. Arjuna thought like this. And Krishna guided him in the entire battle of Kurukshetra and brought victory to the Pandavas. So, this was a consciousness of not only Arjuna, even all the Pandavas. Whereas, see what Duryodhana is thinking. What's the use of Krishna who will not fight? Foolish Arjuna chose him. I will accept the Narayana Sena. I am really smart to get that Sena. Now, considering my great prowess, now all the Pandavas will be finished. They are doomed. This is his own material plan making. You see? So, therefore, we all can ask ourselves, to whom will you be attracted in your life? Someone who genuinely exchanges love with you, like your mother, for example. Or someone flatters you, praising you, oh, you're so beautiful, this dress looks so nice, your hairstyle is very nice and everything. And then they ask you, can you please give me 50,000 rupees? Somebody flatters you and asks for some money from you. Next time they come and praise you, you will ask, hey, what are they going to ask this time? And that's what most people do when they go to the temple. They ask God, give me this, give me that. Actually, we should know that God is a witness. Always, we simply have to love him and he will provide us everything we need without even ever demanding him. Yeah, in the same manner, you will find Hanuman is a pure devotee. He simply wants to serve Sitaram. His heart is flooding with love for them. Yeah, and I heard that once Hanuman asked Mother Sita, why do you wear this kumkum on your forehead? Sita said, Lord Ram likes it very much. Then Hanuman went to a shop and purchased a kumkum packet and put it all over his body and came in front of Ram. How do I look like? And Ram laughed like anything. And Hanuman was satisfied that Lord is laughing very joyfully. But then Lord asked, but why are you like this, Hanuman? Hanuman told the story of what Sita said. And Lord Ram again laughed. So in this way you will find Hanuman simply lives to give pleasure to Ram and Sita. You can see that. On the other hand, people like Ravana want to separate Lord's energy, Sita, away from him and take her to Lanka. Therefore, Prabhupada says, a crying Sita in the hands of Ravana can never make anyone happy. In fact, she destroyed Ravana by being taken to Lanka. On the other hand, a smiling Sita standing next to Ram can bless the whole world. Therefore, we always worship Sita and Ram together, Radha Krishna together, Lakshmi Narayan together, energy and energetic, Shaktiman and Shakti, we worship together. So devotees means we should worship Shakti Shaktiman together. Non-devotees like Ravana or Duryodhana means they want to take only the energy. They want wealth of God, but they don't want Lord himself. Like Ravana wanted kingdom of God without God. You see, Duryodhana, Ravana, Kamsa, Hiranyakashipu, all these fellows have been like that. Even in modern times, we see people want to get lot of money, more money, but they want Lakshmi, but they don't want Narayana. But we are right, Shubha Labha. Shubha means Narayana. Lab means Lakshmi. If you want only Lab, you will get Lobh, greed. That's what happened to Duryodhana. Yeah. Therefore, Lord Krishna chose Arjuna to speak the Bhagavad Gita. Bhaktosime Sakacheti. You see, in this section, 12 to 20 verses, there are 9 signs of victory mentioned here. Krishna was personally present in the battle. One intelligence of Arjuna is, he chose Krishna. That means, you know, wherever there is Krishna, Lakshmi is also there. Either in his chest as a golden hair or in Lord's lotus feet as she is serving Narayana, always massaging his feet. So Lakshmi is never separated from Narayana. Goddess of fortune is never separated from Krishna. So therefore, there was already good fortune blessed right at the beginning of the battle for Pandavas. And here the word is used, Rishikesha, which means Lord. Rishik means senses. Ish means Lord. So Lord of senses was with the Pandavas. So, Lord naturally guided the Pandava senses how to fight the battle and win the battle. Yeah. And also, Kurukshetra is a dharma bhumi, as we discussed before. And Hanumanji also had agreed to sit on the flag of Pandavas and give them a war cry, encouraging them. And I will tell you why Hanuman accepted that role. Later I'll tell you. And also, the shank which was blown, one of the weapons of, I mean, one of the four items which Lord Vishnu uses, isn't it? Shankh Chakra Gada Padma. Like Lord Vishnu, when he blows the shank, it creates auspiciousness to the whole world. When Krishna enters Dwaraka, he blows the shank and immediately all the Dwarakavasis come to receive him. And Prabhupada says that when Lord blew the shank, the lips were reddish, so the whole white shank became reddish by dint of the Lord. Similarly, anything material comes in contact with the Lord becomes spiritualized. So the Pandavas army completely became spiritualized by the presence of Lord Krishna and his blowing of the conch shell, shank. So, and Lord Vishnu touched the head of Dhruva with the shank and made him recite beautiful poetry. So shank and lotus are very auspicious for the devotees. And the gada, which means the mace, and the chakra are for the demons. So, all were Divya Ushankhav, it is said, Pradhat Madhu. Because Krishna is Supreme Lord, Spiritual Lord, the Shankh is called as Transcendental. And Arjuna is follower of the Supreme Lord, so his Shankh is also Transcendental. Yeah. And in this way, Bhishma also blew the Shankh to pacify Duryodhana. At the same time, indirectly, he proclaimed the victory of the Pandavas. And Arjuna was given Agnideva's chariot, which could conquer all directions. Agnideva had gifted him. Yeah, and when the Pandavas blew the shank, it shattered the hearts of the Kauravas. Kridiyani Vyadarayat, it is mentioned in the verse. Whereas when Kauravas blew the shank, that did not shatter the heart of the Pandavas. This clearly shows that Pandavas are here to gain victory because Krishna was with them. So here, Bhishma is blowing the conch shell loudly. Yeah.
Tasya sanjanayan harsham kuru vriddha pitamahah simhanadam vinadyochaihi shankham dadbhau pratapavan.
So Kuru Vridha Pitamaha, the eldest amongst the Kurus, the grandsire, he played the shank. How? Simhanadam, like the roaring of a lion, it is mentioned. And after that, all others also started playing their shank and bugles and drums and everything. They started playing. Here it is mentioned that when he was, why he was playing Bhishma, to encourage Duryodhana. And also he was, his position was like a lion, the greatest grandsire. And his duty was to fight for the Kaurava side. And also, indirectly, he told that the Pandavas will gain victory because Krishna is on their side. Also, Bhishma saw that he is talking so many diplomatic things to different people to shut his mouth up. Therefore, he blew the shank. Suddenly, he took the shank and started blowing. So, Duryodhana will not continue talking like we said in the previous crooked plans I was telling you. Therefore, he played. And Duryodhana also didn't feel bad. Why? Because he was overwhelmed to see Bhishma going ahead and starting the war with a loud blow.
Tata shankascha bheryascha panavanaka gomukah sahasaivabhyahanyanta sashaddastumulobhavat.
After that, all the conchals and drums and bugles and trumpets. Trumpets, you have seen that. All kinds of sounds were played. But why these kind of sounds are played at the beginning of the battle? In those days, the warriors were never scared of death at all. Because they knew very well, if we die in the battle, I will go to heaven. If we win the battle, we will rule the earth. They had no lamentation. So, in fact, Bhishma took the lead and blew the shank. Following him, everybody else blew their shank along with the musical instruments and a sportive spirit. And everybody considered that, you know, I will never turn away from the battle and run away. That would be shame. Rather, I would maintain the honor by fighting the battle and even laying down my life in the battle. And they all came to exhibit the skills in the battlefield. So, this beating of the drums and playing of the different trumpets and everything, these are rituals actually, which stimulate the mood of the event. And these are all Acharya's commentaries, which I am sharing here. When they performed the rituals to encourage everybody for the war. Like in Mridangam is played, if you see in the marriage time, they play. And then there is a Nadaswaram also, played in the marriage occasion also. So, here is the war occasion. There are different type of instruments are played to create the mood of the war. These sounds actually prepare the mind of the warriors. So, there are rituals for spiritual activities, religious activities. There are rituals for marriage. There are rituals for every act, not only devotional practice. So, in this way, the rituals actually create a mood, set a mood and a spirit for entering into the spirit to do the task. So, in the 14th verse, Lord Krishna's grand entry in Bhagavad Gita for the first time. Now, Krishna is coming as a Partha Sarathi. Just see Lord Krishna, how wonderful he is. You see, generally, any hero comes in a movie, they put the camera from behind, they show his shoes, then you are wondering, who is the hero? Then they gradually take it to the front, he is walking, and then they gradually lift it to his hip and the chest, and then they show the face, he stylishly moves his hair, like that he shoots or something. Everybody claps hands, knowing who is the hero of the movie. Very stylishly, heroes generally enter. But here, Lord Krishna wants to gain entry in the Bhagavad Gita, in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita, as a Bhakta Vatsala Govinda or a Partha Sarathi, as a charioteer of Arjuna. Krishna doesn't want to pose himself as God here. You want to show, my dear living beings of this world, look at me. I am becoming servant of my pure devotees. Therefore, take to devotional service and become my devotee. Krishna is welcoming all of us. Just see, he is becoming servant of his own devotee.
Tata shvetairhayair yukte mahati syandane sthitau madhava pandavaschaiva divyau shankhau pradhadmatuhu.
See, here it is said divyau shankhau. Madhava is Krishna, Pandava is Arjuna. They both blew their shank and it is transcendental. Shankar is said. And Sandhana is the chariot. Hayair is the horses. These steeds are the horses were given by Indra and the chariot was given by Agni. So, very powerful combination for Arjuna. And Krishna blew his own shank, Panchajanyam.
पांचजन्यम ऋषिकेशो देवदत्तम धनंजय पौंड्रम दद्भौ महाशंखम भीमकर्मा वृकोदरः.
So now all are playing, praying their respective these things.
Ananta Vijayam Raja Kunti Putro Yudhishthirah Nakula Sahadevascha Sugoshamani Pushpakau Kashyascha Parameshwasah Shikhandi Cha Maharatah Rishtadyumno Viratascha Satyakischa Parajitah Drupado Draupadeyascha Sarvashaprati Vipathe Saubhadrascha Mahabahuhu Shankan Dadmuh Pritak Pritak.
So in this way all the shank names are given, conchal's names are given, who blew which shank, like that. So Prabhupada says, Baladeva Vidya Bhushan says here that Rishikesh means master of the senses. So Lord would help his Pandava army by directing their senses very skillfully and making them fight the battle very valiantly, chivalrously, very powerfully. Yeah. And also Krishna and Arjuna shank is called transcendental. And Madhava is husband of goddess of fortune, Lakshmi. And all this combination victory is certain, it is mentioned. And below the names of the shanks are mentioned. Yeah. You see, it's very important to know, which was unknown to Duryodhana, that there are two types of energies of the Lord, which is the spiritual world, the material world. That is called Parashakti, this is called Aparashakti. So one can actually directly be connected to Krishna in the spiritual world, or we can be indirectly connected to Krishna through the material energy. So one who is attracted only to material energy is called materialist, like Duryodhana. One who is attracted to the Supreme Lord, knowing the material energy also to be Krishna's energy, he is a spiritualist, like Pandavas. So when we are connected to Krishna, the end result is blissful. When we are connected to Maya, material energy, the end result is miserable. So these points are mentioned here about how the living entities are Satchidananda. We are all pure souls. Lord is also pure soul. We are also pure, but we are tiny. Lord is Vibhu and we are called Anu. He is master, we are servant. So this understanding was there with the Pandavas. The Supreme Lord is master and we are all his eternal servants. We have to align with his will. The whole universe is created by him, maintained by him, destroyed by him. And we all are insignificant in front of him. So the different names of Krishna, Arjuna and Bhima are mentioned here, as you see. Krishna means all attractive. Rishikesh means master of senses. Actually, we all possess senses, but we are not their owner. Like for example, imagine a cricketer breaks his leg today while practicing and tomorrow he has to go for the national match. Can he go? Because he can't set right the broken leg. Therefore, he is not the controller of his leg. We have senses, but we didn't create them, nor do we own them. We are only gifted them. Why Krishna has given me the hands, legs, eyes, everything. He is Rishikesh. Madhava means husband of Lakshmi. Achyuta means, we will discuss in the next class, about infallible one. Madhusudana, killer of demon. Madhu, Govinda, one who gives pleasure to the cows and senses. Vasudev means son of Vasudev. Also one who resides in the heart of all. And Devakinandan, son of Devaki, Yashodanandan, Parthasarathi. Keshava, killer of Keshi demon. Janardana, one who is a maintainer of all living entities and killer of the asuras. And the names Dhananjaya means Arjuna brought wealth. And Partha means son of Kunti, Pritha. Gudakesh means one who has conquered sleep. Yeah. Gudakesh has another meaning. Gudaka Isha, which means Guda means sweet. Krishna is also called as the Lord who is sweet, and Arjuna is his friend. And Rukodara means voracious eater, Bhima. So these are the different shanks played. Bhima also had killed many demons such as Hidimba. Arjuna had brought wealth, Dhananjaya is called. Therefore, the outstanding nature of Pandavas is glorified in these verses, whereas in the opposite army, nothing like that is glorified about Duryodhana and others. Yeah. So now the blowing became uproarious.
Saghoshodhartashtranam hridayani vyadarayat Nabhascha prithivim chaiva tumulo bhyanunadayam.
See the second line, hridayani vyadarayat. When Krishna and all the Pandavas blew their shank, the hearts of the enemies were shattered, it is said. Yeah, because of fear and terror by the blowing of this divine conch shells. The enemies were fearful. That's a sign of defeat. In the beginning only they are fearful. Now Arjuna was ready to fight. He looked at the Kuru army, spoke, and then Ata vyavasthitan drishtva dhartarashtran kapidvajah pravritte shastra sampate danurudyamya pandavah rishikesham tada vakyam idamaham ahipate. See, the word kapidvajah is used. Kapi means Hanuman. Hanuman was in the flag of Arjuna, Arjuna's chariot. How he came there, that's a story. I heard from Baladeva Vidyabhushan's commentary. He says here that, you know, you all know, the Setubandha was made by the monkeys. So later on, once when Arjuna was in a pilgrimage, when he went to the Setubandha area, he met one small monkey there and he asked, why the monkeys were engaged by Lord Rama in making the Setubandha? Lord Rama had a bow and arrow, he could have made his own bridge, no? But the monkey said, no. If Rama made a bridge on his own with arrows, we are all many of the monkeys are heavy duty monkeys. When they would walk on that, the bridge would collapse. Therefore, the monkeys were told to make, he said. And Arjuna, hearing this, was shocked. How can you say that Rama can't make a bridge like that? Even I can make a bridge. And then there was a bet between the two. Arjuna said, if I make the bridge and you try to break it, you are unable to break it, then that monkey said, I'll become your servant, he said. And Arjuna said, if I am unable to make a bridge which you can break, then I will enter fire, he said. That was the bet. And then Arjuna made this thing. When Arjuna was making a bridge with the arrows, at that time this monkey was none other than Hanuman. Huh? He was chanting Lord Rama's holy names and gaining some power. After he built the bridge, he broke all the bridge very easily. And Arjuna had his head hanging down. He was very ashamed. He was preparing fire to enter the fire. Immediately one Brahmana arrived there. And the Brahmana arrived there and said, hey, you two of you, you had a competition bet on your own. You didn't involve any witness. Now I am the witness now. Please do that competition again. Now when he said this, now Arjuna became very careful. I got one more chance now. So he was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Tew, 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 tew. He was sending one more arrow chanting Hare Krishna. And then the bridge was made. Now this monkey tried to break the bridge. He couldn't. Then he assumed the form of huge Hanuman. And then now he was shaking the arrows. He just couldn't move them. Now he was defeated now. And Hanuman thought, my Lord, earlier I could break. Why I couldn't break now? Because earlier Hanuman was chanting Ram Nam, so he could break. Now Arjuna was chanting Krishna Nam, but Hanuman stopped chanting. So the bridge became very strong. Seeing this immediately, the Brahmana pacified both of them. Don't worry, you both are my wonderful devotees. And suddenly he assumed the form of, Rama for Hanuman and Krishna for Arjuna. And they were amazed. Oh, the Brahmana has turned into the two lordships. And both of them bowed down. And then Lord Krishna requested Hanuman, Hanuman, both of you are devotees. You should be friends. Please, you occupy the flag and give the war cry when Arjuna would fight, he said. And Hanuman agreed very happily. Very beautiful pastime, isn't it? And here is another pastime. Why Hanuman is in the flag. Bhima, you all know. Once when he was going to forest, he would just uproot trees and throw and kick and everything, animals and everything. So when Hanuman was lying like an old monkey, so he went and asked Hanuman that, he didn't know it's Hanuman. He said, hey, please move aside your tail, he said. Hanuman said, I am a very old monkey, you move it aside yourself. When he tried to lift it, it was so heavy like a mountain. Then he understood it's not an ordinary monkey. Then the monkey smiled at him and said, hey, Bhima, you are my brother. I am also Vayuputra, you are also Vayuputra. They both embraced each other. Hanuman taught him two lessons. Never be proud, even while dealing with the insignificant ones. Another thing he told him, always be righteous. And they both embraced like this. And then he asked him, would you like to join the Mahabharata battle? Hanuman said, no, my war is already over before. Now I am in another age now. But I will agree to cooperate with you by giving a war cry in your battle by occupying the flag, he said. In Thirukkurungudi sculpture, you find this. This shloka is also available. Vijayasya dvajastascha nadan mokshyami darunan shatrunam ye pranaharaha sukam jena hanishyata. Staying in the victory flag, I will shout out fiercely in such a way that it will make the enemies almost lifeless, and thus it will be easy for you to kill them, like that Hanuman said. So Arjuna having Hanuman on his chariot flag is a very great power, because Hanuman was already victorious in Rama's fight against Ravan. Now he is going to give victory to the Pandavas. So these are the signs of victory, that 9 things which I told you earlier. So next class we will discuss about Lord who never fails in his love for devotees. It's called Achyuta. We will discuss that in the next class. Today we finish 12 to 20. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.